Well, dear hearts, this is a work of literature written by the Bard of Avon on Stratford, Georgia. Willie the half-sprung shake. Spear. And all of you have heard the works of Shakespeare, not only the intellectuals or the learned multitudes, but also the 5% that don't think. See, I believe in giving folks the edge. That's weird, ain't it? And just to prove it, here's a Shakespeare quotation. Between your eyes, your beauty lies. You're thinking of the country version. This is the true story of Julius Caesar if it were presented by the down-home players. Now the mighty Caesar have returned from a quail hunting trip down in South Carolina. And on his arm is Mark Anthony, played in the picture by Marlon Brando. And Mark Anthony speaks to the mighty Caesar in his fluent Roman Italian voice, and he say,
"Hey, Julius." And Julius say, "Huh?" He say, "Hey, Julius, like what you want around you, man?" And Julius say, "Well, let me have about me them fat, sleek-headed cats. Said it sleeps all the time and eats all the time and don't never think about nothing." He said, "No time." He said, "Uh-huh." He said, "Julius, you a mess." He said, "Uh-huh." About that time, Mark say, "Hark." "Nay, hark," spake Mark. He said, "Durst." Oh, receive the spirit of that word, dear hearts. Durst, D-U-R-A-S-T. Durst thou not perceive some kind of audible vibration emanating from behind yon potted plant? Says, "Uh-huh," said, "Indubitably I do." Say, "Well, what do it sound like to you?" Say, "Well, what it sound like to me might sound different to you." Say, "Well, what do it sound like to both of us?" Say, "You generalize it." He said, "Well, what it is?" He said, "Now we getting somewhere." He say, "It's the soothsayer and the soothsayer say." Beware the odds of March. What do he mean by that, Julius? And he say, "I doesn't know." But Julius, you just like Kennedy. You supposed to know everything. He said, "I does, but I don't know that." He said, "Julius, too much." About that time, he say, "Hey, Julius." And Julius say, "Huh?" Which is Latin for what? He say, "Julius, what you don't want around you?" And he say, "Oh, don't let me have nobody about me like yon Cassius. Cause he have that lean and hungry look. And said he do not eat, now do he sleep. And he nibbles him no doze in drinking that air wick. And he sits in that little house away from the house and he meditates. Oh, he thinks too much, he about half smart." He said, "Thou hast said." And he say, "Bye, Julius." And he say, "Adios." That's Spanish for bye. Now, straightaway, Cassius is approached by Brutus, the noblest Roman of them all, played in the picture by James Rommel, the desert mason. He say, "Hail, Brutus." He say, "Hail, yes." He say, "Come here, Brutus." He say, "Come here." He say, "All right, what you got on? You mind?" He say, "Uh-huh." He say, "Look, I want you to do something other to Julius." And he say, "How come?" He say, "Cause I say so." He say, "Well, I say so." And he say, "So?" Oh, he departed there running, his blue suede tennis shod feet pounding the pavement. His sheet girded around his being. He swings upon his new swim bicycle, missed the seat. Woo! pedals out through the streets of Rome, Georgia, with his sheet flowing in the breeze and his bicycle clip on his arm to keep the sheet out of the sprocket. Yes, he rides up the steps of the Senate Hall, in through the swinging doors. He stops, jumps off his bicycle. He kicks down the kick-up stand. No, he kicks up the kick-down stand. Kicks the bicycle over again, the door jam. There he's seen Julius. There he's seen Julius. Still sounds right. There he's seen Julius in all of his radiant glory, with this chlorophyll around his head, his arm draped over the television set, eating a locust leg, watching the Helen of Troy story. He say, "Hey, Julius." Well, Julius is happy to see Brutus, beloved, because they've been down to Gaul together, and that's right behind the bladder. And he's ignorant of this premeditated conspiracy to flat get him cooked up by these senatorial cats. So he say,
"Hey." "Hey, Brutus."
Brutus say, "Julius, I have something other for you." And Julius say, "Do." And he said, "Uh-huh." He said, "What hast thou brung, me?" And he says, "Nay, nay, thou hast brought thyself. Grab that, friends. Weigh it." Brutus reached to the depths of the pocket of his sheet, and he withdrew briskly a long, slim, thin switchblade pocket knife. Oh, he presses a button and the blade flies out. Picks it up and sticks it back in the handle. You see, in other words, he reinserted the blade into the source from whence it emanated before he had to press the release mechanism. Ain't that weird? Trying not to be obvious about it, as he smit to Ethric with this here knife, the cutting edge on it was honed to such fine sharpness that when he breathed upon it, it cut the little microbes in two, and they screamed as they fell on each side. Eek, eek. He say, "Here, Julius, hold this." Because it hurt him. The mighty Caesar mortally wounded. The ego ebbing out of his crazy little mixed up fuel pump. His massive feet tangling in Brutus's bicycle spokes. Clasping a great handful of chitterlings. He say, "Et tu, Brutus?" And he said, "No, man, I ain't et nothing."